Hoverbikes, Robocops, air taxis, and jetpack firefighters. Dubai isn't just building the tallest skyscrapers, it's building our future. Know before you go! Number 1. Hoverbikes. The Dubai police have been testing out hoverbikes since 2018. The electrical vertical takeoff and landing bikes, or eVTOL bikes, are produced by a company called Hoversurf. The bikes have a top speed that's capped at 90 km per hour and a suggested safe working height of around 5 meters, although it can go higher. The idea is that the hoverbike makes it easier for the police to track and pursue a suspect and to patrol areas that are hard to access. Although they recently had a crash due to a malfunction, they hope to be actively using these hover bikes sometime next year. Number 2. Dubai's Mega Solar Park. Now hang on a minute, before you go booking tickets, Dubai's solar park doesn't actually have any attractions or rides. It is actually a massive solar power plant, and if plans go ahead, by 2050 it'll be large enough to help Dubai achieve 100% of its power from renewable energy sources. Currently the plant has 5 million solar panels, and its capacity is 1,527 megawatts. It supplies 13% of Dubai's energy mix. By 2030 they hope to reach 5,000 megawatts. But Dubai's solar park doesn't just have solar panels, it also has the world's tallest solar tower. The solar tower uses around 70,000 sun tracking mirrors, or heliostats, to reflect and focus the sun's rays onto the solar tower. Here, the reflected heat melts salt within the tower, and the molten salt provides thermal energy that can be used to heat water to power steam turbines or stored for up to 15 hours. Number 3. Robocop. Dubai's first Robocop joined the force in 2017, and by 2030 they will make up to 25% of Dubai's police force. The idea is that these Robocops take over the more menial tasks involved in policing. Citizens are able to interact with the robots, ask them questions, report crimes, or pay fines. The robots aren't armed or able to make arrests, but they do have cameras and biometric and license plate recognition software, enabling them to identify persons or vehicles of interest and report their locations back to police headquarters. Number 4. Jetpack Firefighters. Dubai has launched the jet ski division of firefighters. These firefighters can quickly dispatch and arrive at the scene of a fire without having to navigate through dense traffic or bottlenecks. Once on the scene, the firefighters use the DOLPHIN system, where powerful jets of water lift the firefighter and their hose into the air. From here, they can then begin to control the fire and even put it out before a standard fire truck has had time to arrive. This isn't the only type of jetpack in the fire brigade's arsenal. 5 years ago, they invested in 20 Martin aircraft jetpacks and 2 simulators to help them fight fires in their incredibly tall skyscrapers. These jetpacks can carry 120 kilos and can be flown manually or remotely. They can reach a maximum altitude of 1,500 meters, although they are capped at 900. The machine can operate in confined areas that helicopters cannot reach. It is very versatile and can be used as a heavy lift payload drone for high-rise rescue, rapid deployment of specialist rescue or tactical teams, surveillance and initial intervention. Number 5. Air taxis. The Volo City air taxi is Volocopter's autonomous vertical takeoff and landing vehicle, which they built in collaboration with Dubai's Road and Transit Authority. The Volo City has 18 rotors powered by 9 rechargeable batteries, and it can carry up to 2 passengers with hand luggage. It can reach speeds over 100 kilometers an hour and has a range of around 35 kilometers. That's 35 kilometers in a straight line, meaning that you could complete the normally over an hour-long journey from JFK Airport to Newark, New Jersey in less than 30 minutes. The Velocity has completed its maiden flight in Germany, as well as multiple test flights in France, and is due for launch in 2024. Number 6. Mars Science City. The Mars Science City will simulate life on Mars. Construction is due to begin this year, and the city will cover an area of 175,000 square meters. That's about 30 football fields. Mars Science City will be a research area that will inspire and educate future generations, and it will be separated into 5 different interconnected domes. There will be a farming park, activity park, and a research park, as well as various exhibition areas. The plan is for the city to be made by first creating a pressurized dome made from a strong radiation-resistant material that will be tied down with a cable net. Once a safe environment is established, robots will evacuate underground spaces to provide maximum protection from the radiation. Next, gigantic 3D printers like the Icon Vulcan will print different buildings using local materials to produce something similar to their own proprietary lavacrete. To maximize farming space and radiation protection, non-productive green areas will be located on the roofs of the buildings and living quarters will be underground. The Mars Science City should be ready to inhabit in 2024, and the version on Mars itself is planned for 2117. Which technology do you think we'll be using in the future? Comment below before you go!